The Lemurians realized very quickly that this was a prime opportunity for them to develop anew their civilization and reestablish their culture on planet Earth. They began working with a group at the time that was known as the Freemasons. The Freemasons, it's very interesting to someone like me who's been around for a while to hear some of the legends and crazy stories I hear people talk about the Freemasons. The Freemasons are a secret society, but they're very much a benevolent society. The Freemasons very seldom get involved in things of war, of conflict. The Freemasons strive to create order in society from behind the scenes to some extent, but they strive to create order and peace and harmony because most of them are very good businessmen. And the Lemurians very much respect that. The Lemurians go about things a little bit differently than the Freemasons did. The Freemasons are also a surviving society from the transition between the fourth and fifth age of man. So the Lemurians worked with the Freemasons to establish America. This may sound very, I guess, insane to some of you that are listening to me, but hear me out for the next few minutes, if you would, please. The Lemurians came to America en masse right around, I would say, the beginning of the 18th century. They developed these 13 colonies in America, each respectively run by their own little microcosm of one of their families. And each family was given a colony. These 13 families that came to the United States. The areas west were of great interest to them because they had never been explored by the Lemurians. It was one of the places on Earth that they had never been. They had traded with people along the coast, just about every place on the planet. But going inland was something that they'd never really had the resources or the expertise or the need or want to do. And so they very much wanted to explore and try to establish trade throughout this great unknown, the Western United States. The concept of gold is, since I've been here at least, always been a very alluring one to humans. Gold is something that will make people do very crazy things. I have seen individuals with water cannons pulverize a mountain in South America and then sift through it and pour liquid mercury into these giant buckets and sift through that so that the mercury will attach itself to the gold to extract it. They're poisoning themselves to get to this gold for a few hundred dollars is what it ends up being for them. This is an amazing time, these last couple of hundred years. It's an amazing time to be alive on this planet. And as this expansion westward came about, one of the more clever things this group did was to come up with the concept, they called it Manifest Destiny, which to the Americans meant that it was their God-given right to have a country that stretched from sea to sea, from coast to coast. And when gold was found in California by early search parties, the Lemurians were beside themselves with opportunity. There became a massive influx of people, not just from the eastern states of the United States at the time, but also from Europe and indeed around the world, that came to the United States to pack their bags and head westward to establish these new cities, these new towns, these new territories, many of whom believed they may find their fortunes in gold. As somebody who spent some time in California, in the United States, I can tell you that even to this day, in some of these remote communities, people exist. They're able to live off the grid. They're able to live completely removed from society because they are able to mine and extract gold and sell it on a regular basis to purchase the things they need to live completely detached from the rest of society. It's amazing, the world around, that gold is a common commodity that is still used today and will probably use tomorrow and forever. And as this expansion occurred, the Lemurians became rich beyond their wildest dreams. They became powerful beyond their wildest dreams. What they had begun as this new potential kingdom for them had become a source of great wealth, a source of great revenue for them. It had replenished those coffers back in Europe. It had paid back many of the debts to the respective kingdoms. There were kings and queens in Europe who wanted to be paid back, especially those in France. When the United States began, there was three main conflicting interests, as I saw it at the time. There were those in Great Britain, there were those in France, and there were those in Spain, who each had staked a claim. Now, there were also Dutch and, of course, Portuguese and Italian. There were some Germans, and, of course, from the Nordic kingdoms up north. But for this particular conversation of which I speak, these three countries, kingdoms, were battling it out for control over the New World, and the Lemurians were the ones that walked away from it. The Lemurians were the ones who retained, and their power flourished in the New World, in what would become the United States of America. In the United States of America, there's, in their histories, a concept taught of they call them their founding fathers. And these gentlemen were believed to have written their constitution and established that brand of government on the planet. This constitution was written by individuals, or influenced, excuse me, I don't know if the individuals that actually penned the Constitution were of Lemurian descent, but the influence was definitely there. The idea that everyone has within them this free agency, that as long as that free agency did not encroach upon someone else's, they should be left alone to live their life, was a core principle in Lemurian culture. It was in everything that they did, and it was the reason why the Lemurians didn't want to have much to do with the rest of the world while they could control that. And it's also the reason why the Lemurians are slow to offer up information to the masses that exist on Delta Sol right now. It's why many of these great societies are slow to offer up this information. A culling of the population on Earth will meet many of their needs. It's not that they wish many of you to die. It's that you've become unmanageable. You've become so large. You've become so well-educated that you've become very difficult to manage. There are, within the last 100 years, individuals who have become rich on a scale that frightens some of these people in power on your planet, from these ancient houses. Now, these ancient houses are the topic of another conversation, but the Lemurians established America to have what they believed the easiest form of trade, of global trade, that would best suit their interests for that global trade. Did I say that correctly? Did I say that clearly? America was established to be a commerce-friendly country. It's been that way for a long time, and it's made these people very powerful once again, and they desperately want to retain that power. But they've been involved, in the beginning, they were involved in wars to defend their sovereignty, to defend this newly formed nation. Then they were involved in wars at the beginning of the 20th century, towards the middle of the 20th century, to assist the kingdoms to which they were beholden in Europe. Then they became entangled in what they refer to as the Cold War, and that's been the demise of the Lemurian civilization that we know now as the United States of America. The powers that be in America were very concerned about the powers that existed in Northern Asia. They'd been distrusting of one another for centuries. They had become allied during the Second Great World War in the 1940s because they wanted to defeat a common enemy, this Axis powers, Japan, Italy, Germany at the time, who were just soldiers from another ancient family. Very often in the history of your planet, old money buys new blood. This old money just changes from the left to the right hand. And the masses, the bottom of the pyramid, those individuals are the ones whose lives are affected. Now, as this tape, it looks like it's going to end, so I'm going to give the crash course, I guess, on the remainder of what I wanted to say. I wish I could manage my speak better. The individuals who came to power in America did so because they allowed the population to grow rapidly, feeling the population honestly felt they were in control of their own destiny. Through the system of democracy that they established in America, people believed that they could cast their vote and elect leaders that had their best interest at heart. And indeed, many of them did, and many of them do today. But behind the scenes, those who are put in position from one respective party or another are put there by this same group, the same family that has controlled America since the beginning of the 18th century. And these 13 different sects of this culture, these 13 families that came to America, that have been controlling it, and in the last 50 years controlling the entire planet, are once again in a position where their backs are against the wall. The individuals in America have gotten out of control with what they call a credit society. This means, to those of you who are unfamiliar with this term, people in America don't have to have money in order to obtain something. They can borrow against future earnings and have to pay that back with a thing that they call interest. And the people in America, because it's the nature of the people in the bottom of the pyramid to strive, it's human nature to want more, they've taken shortcuts to get there. And it's undermined that economy to the extent that it can no longer support this society that Lemuria has built up in America. And the Chinese, my dear friend Sun Tzu, in China, tells me that China, the United States, owes the Chinese about $1 trillion. That's an amount of money that's, trust me, you cannot comprehend how much money that is. It's a lot. And the Chinese are going to start telling America they need to pay that back. And America can't pay that back. The Lemurians are once again faced with their society going into hiding, once again losing control of their kingdom, this time not through no fault of their own, not through the course of nature of a natural disaster, but because of their own perceived mismanagement. Heck, I think that's an iceberg alarm. Anyway, that would be weird to see an iceberg this far north. It's going to be a crazy time in the United States over the next 2 years. What's going to happen is that the credit economy is going to, it's already imploded. They're going to try to revitalize it by switching the form of currency. Americans are going to be offered a new form of banking, a new form of finance. Most of them will choose to be embedded with a radio frequency ID chip. They'll be enticed to do this by a credit. You'll be given basically free money to join into this new system. This will be done so that they can print a large quantity of money, pay off the Chinese, and try to walk away from their debt with paying it off with worthless paper. This tape is going to end. I'll try to continue on some other time.